Captain's log. Stardate 123456.7. The human race is once again facing possible extinction. Marriage has been forsaken, and all procreation has ceased. Unless a solution can be found to this problem, mankind is surely doomed. So upon my request, myself and the crew of the Enterprise will once again attempt time travel, returning to the early 21st century to observe and learn from my childhood hero, and whom I've patterned my career after, and what history records as the greatest marriage of all time, between Rob and Amanda Stafford. Spock, where are we? Captain, we have arrived in the early 21st century, precisely on April 8th in the early PM. However, due to time distortion through the wormhole, we will experience temporary metabolic change. Great, Spock, on screen. Amanda, Rob, I am James T. Kirk, captain of the USS Starship Enterprise. I've come to you from what you would consider the future. We have a problem we need your help with. We must learn the secret to your powerful love and return to our own time in order to save all mankind. You'll have to forgive me if I seem a bit awestruck, but Rob, you were my childhood hero. I've patterned my life after you. I've read all of the great books written about your incredible accomplishments and gone to the required Starfleet Academy course of Amanda and Rob's How to Create the Perfect Marriage and Still Remain Cool.
Captain, I am picking something up on scanners.
Spock, what is it?
Captain, it's a screen I look into that shows me what's going on outside the ship, but that's not important right now.
No, Spock, what do you see?
Another ship has followed us through the wormhole.
Spock, surely you're mistaken.
No, Captain, I'm not mistaken, and don't call me Shirley. Captain, the ship has fired torpedoes.
Red alert! Sulu, shields! Shields! Spock, damage report.
Shields are down. Weapons are non-responsive, and propulsion is offline.
Caught with my pants down again.
Captain! We're receiving word from the other ship.
Uhura, on speakers.
Kirk, my old friend.
Khan! Oh, friend, why have you followed us?
Kirk, mine is a superior intellect. Did you not think that word of Amanda and Rob's nuptials would reach the farthest ends of the galaxy?
Khan! What are your intentions?
Kirk, you were in no position to be demanding my intentions. However, I shall give them to you anyway. My intentions are to destroy this so-called greatest marriage of all time with my photonic wave anti-marriage super-duper torpedo. And then, I shall deprive you of your life.
Khan! Khan!
Captain, Khan has fired his photonic wave anti-marriage super-duper torpedo.
Spock! Do something!
Captain, something has appeared between Khan's missile and Earth.
Spock, what is it?
I can't tell.
Spock, you can tell me. I'm the captain.
It's pure energy. Captain, the energy source has absorbed Khan's torpedo.
Khan, like a poor marksman, you keep missing the target.
Captain, the energy source is moving into Khan's ship.
No, it's not possible. History records your death.
That's right, Khan. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, and the king has returned. I ain't gonna let the likes of you ruin the biggest day of my two biggest fans. You're about to take a long walk down Lonely Street, my boy. Rob, Amanda, congratulations. Sincerely. Thank you for being my two biggest fans. I'll never be far away. I gotta get going. Big guy upstairs can't get enough of the king. Thank you very much. Captain, the energy source has disappeared and Khan's ship is gone.
Great, Spock!
Rob, Amanda, I believe we learned what we need to save all mankind. It's the powerful love you share. Love. I've got the disease. I love her. She loves me. Now I know they call it she. I'd love to tell you about your beautiful future together and the wonderful years you have together. All of your 15 children. But I fear I'd ruin the timeline. Congratulations to both of you on this, your greatest day. Enjoy the journey together. Spock, do you have anything you'd like to say?
Yes, Captain. Being Vulcan, this love you speak of is foreign to me. But if I were human, I believe my response would be, cherish it always. Hold on to it. If I were human, live long and prosper.